पुणे बिनाले 2017। Only a Biennale can make this year significant and memorable in the history of Pune. Since 2013, Pune Biennale has been synonymous with engaging public art in public spaces by partnering with Pune Municipal Corporation, making art available to the larger public and giving city artists an exposure to creating in the public sphere has not only been possible, but rather the driving force for Pune Biennale. Coming up shortly in the third edition of Pune Biennale 2017, headed by an extremely qualified board of directors, coupled with an exceptional team of advisors committed to the vision of Pune Biennale Foundation, by the constant support of our sponsors and patrons, and all connected by the passion for the art in the public sphere. As a run-up to the main festival, Pune Biennale 2017 organized a series of precursor events including talks and interaction sessions by Daniel Wapples, Sudarshan Shetty, Prabhakar Kolte, Pooja Sood and Abhay Sardesai, shedding light on various art-making process, art form, curation while conceptually exploring images. Making sure that every citizen has something to relate to in the Pune Biennale 2017. An inclusive art workshop for specially abled children met with an overwhelming response.
So for me, the interaction and just seeing the joy that they get from the whole process, I think that activity itself brings so much joy and so much excitement.
This art includes only paperwork actually.
It was just great fun to see the joy and enjoyment and the sense of achievement that the kids felt after making their products or their things.
So in the whole process, all the kids really had fun and they enjoyed it.
The upcoming art treat from 5th to 29 January 2017 promises a host of projects across the city, connecting not just artists from India and abroad, but also traditional art spaces and unconventional arenas for creating and displaying art. Habit, Cohabit, one of our main projects, curated by Jasha Kola and Luca Seriza.
The title Habit Cohabit is a wordplay and relates to how it's necessary sometimes to change our habits in order to cohabit, to live together.
In each space, it wasn't a vacuum or an empty, neutral space, but one that already had a lot of symbolic value, a lot of
artistic
visual and material already, a whole inheritance of meanings. And the artists really fit within these meanings and try to either mimic the rituals, the everydays of everyday life in these spaces, and also to adjust and intervene within that.
We decided to, we adopted an attitude of asking the artist to really confront with the existing condition.
Installing art and making intervention in Pataleshwar Caves, Jangli Maharaj Temple, Abel Underpass, Modern High School, Fule Museum, PMC Printing Press, Sambhaji Park and the Z Bridge. Citizens can look forward to a range of mediums like sound installation, video games, performance art, installation art, as well as paintings and sculptures in a new light.
Pune Biennale is about public spaces in our city. It is about how art and visual arts, visual aesthetics can enrich our public spaces. So essentially the idea is that people express themselves as citizens of this city and come and enjoy the public domain.
A project which is for the outdoors, a project which is to do with public spaces. I work with public spaces, so we need to emphasize on public spaces, make it more inclusive, take people in into the project, work with people who work with public spaces.
Pune Biennale 2017 offers you a unique opportunity to experience a public garden as not just a garden and a walk through containers with artworks creating moving art spaces, conceived around the theme of migration by curator Bina Sarkar.
It's critical to think of migration, because migration has been forever, from the beginning of man, one of the aspects that has been natural to us. Whether it's birds, animals, the human species, we migrate for because of climate change, because of economic reasons, because of war, we migrate. Earlier we had no nations, now we have nations, we have boundaries, we have many constraining factors. Do we need them? Do we need nations? Do we need boundaries? This is what we're questioning.
ज्या दिवशी आम्हाला याचे बिनालेच्या इव्हेंटची माहिती मिळाली त्या दिवसापासून आम्ही इकडे गुलटेकडीला व्हेकल डेपोला इकडे आम्ही आलो आहे आणि मेटल जंकमधलं तिथलं स्क्रॅप मटेरियल आम्ही गोळा करून ते कामाला सुरुवात केलेली आहे.
यावर्षी मी पुणे बिनालेमध्ये जो काही आम्हाला बिना सरकार मॅडमनी मायग्रेशन नावाचा सब्जेक्ट दिला होता तर त्या सब्जेक्टमध्ये केनियन ॲनिमल असतो एक ॲक्च्युली विल्ड बीस्ट नावाचा त्याचा तो प्राणी आहे. आपल्या इथे सापडत नाही तो, पण रानगवा, हरिण आणि याक अशा तिन्ही ॲनिमल्सला कंबाईन करून असं ते त्या ॲनिमल्स हायब्रिड ॲनिमल आहे ॲक्च्युली तो.
PMC was so glad to hear that, and they came on board only with this thought that we will be able to create the city's junk into artworks. And since then, Pune Biennale never looked back.
So the game is like a multiplayer game, it's a sandbox game. About 30 to 40 people can log in, and they log in from their cell phones actually. And the game is about the city of Pune, it's about moving around in the city of Pune and consuming. So you keep buying apartments and you keep buying products, which is actually upsetting the ecological balance, and the whole idea is to keep that balance intact.
So for me things like site and place are extremely important, and the Pune Biennale to me functions at that level. So for the second work I'm doing, for instance, it'll be in a garden in a park, and it's also of interest to me because I love the idea of the indoor and the outdoor within cities, how people interact with architecture when they're outdoors and how they interact with that when they're in a public museum, for instance, like this one.
And we are going to demonstrate this particular aspect through this particular pavilion. This is a basic model to evaluate the structural stability and the joinery system of the pavilion, and in around 5 days we'll be working day and night to execute this.
As an architecture student, Pune Biennale helps us understand different facets of design that we don't really get to see otherwise, and the exposure of working with so many artists and from different countries and different backgrounds, it's a great experience.
This is a kind of a canopy being made, you know, around the entrance canopies that the students of architecture are involved in doing. And these students are from PVP College, for instance, here. And I'm told that the students are from first, second and third year.
उद्या पुणे बिनालेच्या कार्यक्रमाला सुरुवात होते. या ठिकाणी पुणे महानगरपालिका आणि बाकीची जी काही मंडळी आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये भारतीय विद्यापीठ समूह आहे, या सगळ्या मंडळींनी एकत्रित येऊन पुणे बिनालेच्या या सगळ्या संकल्पनेला सुरुवात केलेली आहे. पुणे शहर हे आशिया खंडातलं 8वं शहर आहे, महाराष्ट्रातलं हे 2 क्रमांकाचं शहर आहे. या शहराच्या संदर्भातल्या ज्या ज्या चांगल्या गोष्टी केल्या पाहिजेत त्या संदर्भात पुणे महानगरपालिका निश्चित प्रयत्नशील आहे.
आय वुड लाईक टू रीच आउट अँड थँक PMC फॉर ऑल देअर सपोर्ट अँड आर व्हेरी डायनॅमिक कमिशनर मिस्टर कुणाल कुमार फॉर अंडरस्टँडिंग आवर विजन अँड टेकिंग हेल्पिंग अस पुट इट टुगेदर.
खूप खूप आनंद आहे आम्हा सगळ्यांना की पुणे बिनालेचा तिसरा एडिशन हा इतका सक्सेसफुली पुण्यात पार पडतो आहे, आणि पुण्याच्या एक ऐतिहासिक जंगली महाल रोडवर पुणे बिनालेचा यंदा आम्ही 8 वर्ष डिस्प्ले करतो आहे. आणि मला अभिमान वाटतो, आनंद वाटतो सांगायला की जवळजवळ 200 अधिक आर्टिस्ट यामध्ये सहभागी होत आहेत आणि अनेक देशातले राज्यातले महाराष्ट्रातल्या वेगवेगळ्या जिल्ह्यातले असतील देशाच्या वेगवेगळ्या राज्यांमधले आणि परदेशातून अनेक आर्टिस्ट यामध्ये सहभागी होत आहेत. सो वी हॅव अ पोस्ट लार्ज नंबर ऑफ आर्टिस्ट पार्टिसिपेटिंग विथ द आर्ट वर्क्स अँड इट सीम्स व्हेरी एक्सायटिंग अँड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू इट. थँक्यू.
Come and explore art and public spaces in a never-before-experienced way. Pune Biennale 2017 awaits you.